Hi, and thank you for joining me for my quick demonstration and overview of all my custom designed modules for the Vera ToolCheck Modular. The Vera ToolCheck Modular is their newest iteration of the ToolCheck lineup, and it is very handy if you just want to grab it in a pinch and have everything at hand to get the job done. I try to lay out everything roughly in the way it will fit together later, with all the original components on the bottom and all the additions on top. Please make sure to disassemble the modular first and then print out the three main components as well as any additional parts. So let's take a look at the screwdriver first. Albeit being appropriately sized for the modular, it is a little bit small in my hand and doesn't support a ratcheting function. Fortunately for us, Vera already makes a small form factor ratcheting screwdriver. It's called the 838 RAS. It's a little bit bigger in the hand, more comfortable to use, and sports a ratcheting function, which is always a plus. To mount it to the 3D printed holder, we first have to extract the original rubber retention ring. To do that, simply push in and turn counterclockwise. If you don't feel it budging, use some small pliers or small flathead screwdriver to dislodge the flaps from the included ridge. After that, simply pull out at an angle. To mount it to the 3D printed holder, just perform the actions in reverse. Push it in at an angle, make sure it's flush with the face, and then turn clockwise. Now it's firmly seated in place and doesn't go anywhere. Then mount the ratcheting screwdriver and you're good to go. I also included a holder for the Olight O-clip on the right. The Olight O-clip is a very handy small form factor but also surprisingly long lasting USB rechargeable LED light with a clip at the back and a pretty strong magnet to make sure all your tight spaces are well illuminated when working. To mount it onto the holder, simply clip it on top and push down. Notice how the little hole here makes sure you don't need to worry about the O-clip getting loose. On the back here, I included a space for the Fisher Space Pen. Notice that I have the bullet variety with only the chrome finish and no additional coating. Simply remove the cap and push it completely into the holder, making sure it's as far down as possible. Don't worry if it feels a little tight. It is exactly designed to do that, so that you can simply pull out the pen without the cap, so you don't need to worry about that when simply wanting to quickly write something down. Put it back in, and if you ever want to get the cap out, either use some small pliers to pull it out here, or use a very fast motion to dislodge it a little bit. Put the pen in again and try again until you get the cap out completely. To then insert it again, push down firmly, and you have restored the intended functionality. We can now already mount this module onto the official bit module. Simply slide it down the right side. Attach the connector and while holding the back part firmly in place, slide the top cover down, making sure it's fully seated. If you don't do it correctly, like I just did, you might still have the right tab or the left tab sticking out, which means you wouldn't be able to open it. To correct that, simply pull out the side again, making sure to push this side in completely and remount. And now it works fine. We will put this part away first and take a look at the dual Knipex holder. This part slides onto the left part of the included micro driver module. To the left of the dual Knipex module, we will put the original Allen key holder. You now can put in both a Knipex Cobra in the 125mm variant, as well as the 125mm Knipex pliers wrench. Notice that it doesn't impede the pulling out of the microdriver bits while still remaining easily detachable and not budging. This part also includes a dual bit holder. I found the included spring ring bit holder to be a little bit lacking, so I included a part where you can put a Vera wrap adapter, which is very nice for one hand operation and putting in and pulling out of the bits, as well as the DeWalt Extreme locking and magnetic bit holder. Both also don't fall out on their own. As I found both magnets to be a little bit weak to support bigger screws or longer bits, I also included the functionality to hold the German brand KWB magnetic bit holder, which has a very strong magnet and is very nice to use. To complete the assembly, simply push the connector in, and then also, while making sure to push in the back part, mount the top cover. Now onto the last part, the utility knife holder. It is designed to hold an Olfa SVR2 slimline utility knife. It is a very handy small knife for lightweight tasks and even some heavier, although of course the blade isn't as thick as the bigger brother, and having snap-off blades. To mount this to the holder, you need to remove the clip. After that, you can simply slide the knife onto the holder. As you can see though, the original clip had a little slit there to break off the blades. I have also included this in my holder. To mount it to the tool jack, simply slide it into the little slots present on the original Allen key holder. Now you can also easily break your blades off if you need a fresh cutting edge. Simply break it off and carefully remove the broken off blade. As you probably also need some replacement blades at hand, I included a small blade magazine on the bottom of the holder. Simply slide the blades into the opening and cap it off with the included cap. As you can see, I also added a small ridge right here to either pull it off with a fingernail or by using a small flathead screwdriver. Mount the knife on top again, and you have yourself an upgraded Vera ToolCheck modular. The nice thing about that is that it still is very compact. All the modules end at a specific height. Everything is flat, so it can stand on its own, or if you want to have it stand like that, it can do that too. And still having easy access to all the different parts of the ToolCheck. You can also use the LED light while standing it somewhere if you can't use the clip or the magnetic bit. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have as much fun with the ToolCheck modular as I have.